Bitcoin has fallen, and traders have been panicking for the last few days, worrying that the bull market is over and that we are going to hit rock bottom. I will explain why this is not the case. I will explain why we will grow, when, from where and where we will grow. Plus, I will share a couple of potentially missed, very lucrative ideas that are still relevant. You will be surprised, to say the least, at the opportunities to earn on the market in the near future. I will talk about this in this video. Videos are rarely released on the channel, so I recommend subscribing to other social networks using the links below. Now, this moment I didn't comment on, but here was an ascending triangle, went beyond the resistance, entered the key zone, then there were $46,000 established there, and suddenly couldn't resist, and went into the negative in a day. At the same time, altcoins mostly didn't show much activity, they didn't go along with Bitcoin and seemed to have ended their rally, went down by 30-40%. I hope none of you lost money on this. I hope that you trade with stop losses as I have taught you. If not, there is a corresponding playlist with training on my channel. You can see what it was, why everything fell. Let's examine this in more detail. Let's go to Bitcoin and look here in the ascending triangle when exiting and securing. It should have taken off vertically. The same thing should have happened in this ascending wedge. We should have soared vertically. We were in it for a very long time. I began to doubt that we were in the bullish phase. Maybe this wedge will close down, but no. The idea was to short only from this zone when it breaks down. The breakout didn't happen. I went long from the breakout upwards. This was the priority scenario. They took off vertically. Everything is as it should be. Here too, we were supposed to take off vertically, but the only thing is that there was no scenario for shorts at all, and there still isn't. Let me explain why they fell. News about the ETF, many started to buy, then either it's fake news or it's not. In the end, they approved part of the ETF. We already know this, but it turns out that on January 11th, there was a huge volume in the hourly candles. I went in, looking at the breakout of the maximum, that is, at the high of this and last year, we are entering on a huge volume, meaning a lot of people here rushed to buy. Suddenly, for some reason, the market did not support this movement. Everyone who bought here, they are leaving either due to stop losses or due to liquidation beyond the nearest levels. The nearest levels were obvious, it's highlighted here. I won't emphasize it separately, since here's the second level and the third level is here. Everyone in this position. Stops were activated here at first, then here, and thirdly here. But more likely, these were liquidations here. A significant participant with large holdings entered this volatile part within an hour at a huge volume, and they were liquidated. Therefore, there are no more stops, no more liquidations are being planned. And overall, nothing else occurred in the market other than this panic attack at the highs and the exit due to the stops and liquidations. The fundamentals are positive. An ETF on Bitcoin has been approved. Money will gradually flow into this market, not immediately and not abruptly. We won't skyrocket to double the current value in the span of a day, but in the future, it's certain that billions will flow in here like a river. Moving on, the question arises, why did altcoins fall? Let's look at it sequentially. Ethereum has not fallen, it has a strong setup potential to double, crossing key moving averages. On a daily frame, it is about to skyrocket. It's conquering the maximum, overcoming resistance. Everything is in line with the canon of a bull market. And let me remind you that we are indeed in a bull market. If anyone is thinking of short selling, ask yourself this question. Is my current idea in line with the market, the trend? If someone is thinking about short selling here, or is already short selling, God forbid, most likely not, you are not on a trend, at least on a daily frame. Ethereum is performing well. Many coins are still gradually growing. There's a correction. Some are flat, like a cup with a handle, some kind of, I don't know, contraction. An ascending triangle is forming. The potential is like a bull market. only upward. Now, the coins that have fallen, let's move a little lower on the list. Litecoin crashed. How come? But it was bought up in volume, and even at a slightly larger volume, they went higher. Everyone who was short selling here, significant volumes were present. They were closed by stops, by liquidations. Here, the volume was even more substantial. Here, slightly more were bought up, nothing much happened, but attention should be paid. On the same Litecoin, the entire volume was not just bought up from the short sellers, they returned home. That is, this is the pro-trading zone. We returned exactly to it, nothing supernatural. Omisego retraced until it returned. But it's still standing. There are ascending lows, everything is in line with the bull market. Just a correction, just a retracement. Tron is one of the strongest setups in the ascending triangle. It seemed under the Ross line, it broke through the trend here. I tried to short it here, but no, it was bought back and held at the level. Plus, we approached the resistance with a squeeze. The potential here is such that if you shift a little to the left, look at this pattern. Potential somewhere between double to triple in the next few months. Let's move on. This is not what I wanted to show you. Where you can enter, there are even better opportunities that you might have missed. Stellar, it seemed, has a mega flat. Did it change? Stellar, казалось бы, mega flat при смене. When the trend shifts from bullish to bearish, we need to break through the flat and plummet by 50%. Nothing like that can be seen here, not even under the moving average, not even with bearish engulfing. Trading volume increases and everything remains stable, even bought back a bit higher. Currently, we're at the bottom edge of the channel in the flat, but there are bullish signs present. Nothing catastrophic, we've bought all the panic sellers out, everything's fine. We went down to the bottom edge in a manner, but saw a drop there by 20%. Well, that's the altcoin market for you. I'm new to the market and haven't seen anything like this before. Such things happen. The question is, alright, there was a crash. Okay, everything was bought up and held up. In some places, there was a bullish takeover. Even breakouts at the level occurred and are going to occur somewhere. But what was that? It's normal for a high market and normal for a bullish market. Firstly, secondly, let's look at Bitcoin dominance here. During this Bitcoin crash, there was a stronger collapse of altcoins. Dominance grew, but now it's decreasing. It's already approaching its recent minimum values, nearing the 200-day moving average. This implies that if the dominance decreases, Bitcoin will remain stagnant. The altcoin will grow and dominance will decrease. Bitcoin will rise, altcoin will skyrocket, dominance will decrease. Bitcoin may fall, altcoin might stay still, or not drop too much, or might even rise altogether. Looking at the decrease in dominance, the potential is 22%. Let's assume that Bitcoin remains steady, and dominance decreases simply because the risk-on mode is activated in a conventional market. It cannot but activate even if we don't go higher in Bitcoin. Well, the potential for altcoins is clear. That is, Bitcoin dominance drops from 50% to 22%, which might seem strange, but if you calculate the percentages, the altcoin market should grow by a factor of 2.5 probably. But before that, before the most exciting content and potential money-making trading ideas, I remind you that I trade on the Bybit exchange. I recommend everyone to switch to it. From Binance, I switched to Bybit. As for the new stuff, I always said that they give $100 for a deposit using the link below. It remains the same, maximum liquidity, lowest commissions. For some reason, I don't have this on this specific page, but I did see that some of my students, when they sign up through my referral link, they get more. There is a bonus option for $10. Pay attention, for those who make a deposit of $3,000, they give you an extra 100 as the bonus. This is in the rewards section, you can claim it. Those who deposit $250,000, they give you $30,000 as a bonus. However, you still need to increase your trading volume in order to receive the $100. You just need to press sell on $3,000. The volume is small change. But for those who don't have $3, there are such cases, I know. They can give you $10 for a modest deposit, probably $100. But for some reason, not everyone sees this promotion. It's not displayed to everyone. Go to the link below, look at this section, and see what kind of bonuses you have here. Some are given, some only receive at least $100, but I think that essentially they will receive $100 more or less if they want. Not everyone has 3,000 on the exchange balance, but to get a free $100, you can transfer it from the shadows, especially since replenishment from Russia via peer-to-peer has 0% commission. Now let's move on to ZCash trading ideas. Look at what happened to him. I was long on ZCash. I already earned almost twice with triple leverage. I entered almost at the very bottom. I also gave the same advice to my students during personal mentoring. 26% was already gained from below, but it's still at the bottom below the minimal trading zone. At the moment of this long guide, Dash dropped to all-time low. If it was standing here at the highs, here it dropped by 20%. Pay attention. The volumes are colossal. The volumes are enormous. The liquidation levels are off the charts. And this whole thing is getting bought back. The market is bullish. The altcoin is growing. Bitcoin's dominance tends to decrease. What will happen as soon as Bitcoin's dominance begins to decline sharply, when Bitcoin will begin to grow sharply, when money enters the altcoin market, many coins will take off. Well, maybe not all, right? But over the last long period, there will be highs in a year or two, and these coins will be sold off. Even if liquidity doesn't immediately flow into the most lagging coins, what will happen when these coins grow back? They will drop, people will take profits here, where will the money go? Into the catching up coins. ZCash is a coin with the clearest bottom pattern that I have seen in the last 5 years. Probably in the 18th year, I saw similar patterns, as now with ZCash. How many years have already passed? Now is the 24th year, by the way. It was a long time ago. I recommend not to miss this opportunity. Long, I'm sitting with triple leverage. I already have good profit rates there. The potential is colossal. Hundreds of percent even just on a rebound, without any overshoot, without some kind of native. Well, the native there says, scary. Who missed 2017? 2020. Don't miss 2024. Subscribe. Good luck. And don't forget $100 for registering and depositing on Bybit.